ये उनको कोई बहुत स्पेसिफिक चीज इंडिया के लिए करनी पड़ेगी, बट द फैक्ट इज दैट दे आर सेलिंग द सेम एयरक्राफ्ट टू इजिप्ट, टू एमिरेट कंट्रीज इन विच दे वुड सर्टेनली हैव बिल्ट इन दैट फीचर फॉर ऑपरेटिंग एट अ हाई हाई टेम्परेचर.
I think what you mean is it is possible that after the original, let's say, when the tenders were submitted or when the price bids were submitted, that between that time and 2015-16, maybe it's possible that there was some technology which had come as a result of which the Air Force might have wanted a few more things along with it. It's possible. But you see, there is also a procedure to go through for procuring them. They would have to be firstly, this requirement has to come from the services. Secondly, thereafter it has to go through the categorization committee as to whether, because these upgrades are not something which you necessarily have to buy. May or may not be something which you necessarily have to buy with Dassault, but in any case, it has to go through all these processes, through the categorization committee, thereafter through the Defence Acquisition Council, etc. And there has to be some way of determining what is the appropriate price for these upgrades. You can't just say that, look, we like a particular helmet, there is a new technology helmet which has come, and we'll buy that helmet for a few hundred crores. You can't say that. So it has to be some process for that. It has to be some method of ascertaining. Otherwise, those same scams will continue, which have been going on for a long time. And so I'm not saying that it is not possible that there could have been some upgrades. Notwithstanding these statements that they will come, it is in a joint statement that these will come in exactly the same configuration as has been tried and approved by the Air Force. Even when he signed the 36 aircraft deal. But assume that there were some further add-ons that the Air Force wanted. Let them say, when did the Air Force ask for it? When was this SQR done? When was this categorization committee approved it? When did the AON, when did the DAC give their AON for these, and how was the price determined? That's why we are saying, you can't shroud this whole deal in secrecy, it's absurd. You come out, come clean, let the country see what is what, and the country will be able to, people will be able to make up.
So actually, Vishnu, your argument works the other way. The point is, you are saying there was add-on, India-specific add-on. If they had been spread over 126 planes, they would have been 550 the plane, assume something. But because they are all being concentrated on 36 planes, then actually they become 15 rupees a plane. But that is the reason to continue with 126 planes on the economy of scale. Rather than saying, I will buy only one aircraft and make that so expensive because the entire development of technology will have to be costed for that one plane. So it is the other way around that you are arguing.
So can I ask a question? You know, in the Bhopal scam, you know, the disclosure came by the Swedish radio in 87, you remember. And that disclosure gave the three payments that were made in 86 and the war. And there was a specific allegation of a kickback in the Bhopal deal. Commission of kickback, because the Prime Minister got up and said in Parliament there were no middlemen, and he got caught on that, because had he said there were middlemen, and if there were middlemen, he would have got caught. But anyway, he got caught. Now the point here is that till now there is no specific allegation of a kickback. There is an inference of a kickback on the basis of the offset provided to a private company, 70%. Which is about 21,000 crore. And that perhaps, you know, leaves a bit hamstrung the efforts to get at the truth, maybe through bringing on board the courts, you know, for them to order an inquiry.
The government of its own will not order anybody because it is justifying its action. And even the demand for a joint parliamentary committee may not be conceded by the government. Now, my question is that finally this league will have to go to the Comptroller and Auditor General because public money has been spent. And the CAG's report will have to be tabled in Parliament and ultimately sent to the Public Accounts Committee. So, in the interregnum, is there a possibility of getting the truth known through other means? Is there a possibility?
You are quite right in saying that we have not been able to so far identify any transaction which will lead to the allegation of kickbacks or illegal payment. But that is yet to start. The deal has just been signed and the arrangement, the infrastructure has been put in place. The HAL has been there. We would not be making that time. If the offset agreement had been with HAL, then we would not be making that. But because the private party has been brought in, at this stage we can say with certain confidence that the infrastructure for commission payment has been put in place. And they will start accruing as the planes start coming. All this will be exposed, I have no doubt in my mind. Enterprising, investigating journalists here and in France will do it. But at the moment, we will only say that there is the infrastructure which has been created. Otherwise, there was no need for a private party to be brought into the offset.
Sir, two other points. One is, it is not correct.